If it is greater than means the feasible region is away from the origin, above the origin. And the non-negative restrictions are x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is greater than or equal to 0. There are two inequalities. Let us convert these two inequalities into equalities. Hello dear students, welcome to this session of mathematics class. I'm Mr. Niranjan, Faculty of Mathematics, Vidyashram PU College, the Temple of Excellence. In my previous class, I have discussed problems regarding linear programming. So, how to solve a linear programming problem using graphical method. Now, in this session also, I am going to discuss few more problems to solve linear programming problem graphically. This type of problems are very important for 6 marks. Now, let us consider a first problem. Solve the following linear programming problem graphically. Minimize and maximize. The objective function is both. It is to be minimized as well as maximized. That means you have to find the minimum value as well as the maximum value of the function. Z is equal to x plus 2y. Subjected to the constraints. What are the constraints given? X plus 2y is greater than or equal to 0. 2x minus y is less than or equal to 0. And 2x plus y is less than or equal to 200. So, there are three variables. That is, three equations are given. There are three constraints. X plus 2y is greater than or equal to 0, 2x minus y is less than or equal to 0, and 2x plus y is less than or equal to 200. And the non-negative restrictions, x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is greater than or equal to 0. Now, first, let us convert these inequalities into equalities. Now, there are three equations. Let us consider the first equation. X plus 2y is equal to 100. And the second equation is 2x minus y is equal to 0. And the third equation is 2x plus y is equal to 200. Okay, now solve this. As usual, put x is equal to 0. If you put x is equal to 0, you will get 2y is equal to 100. Therefore, y is equal to 100 divided by 2 is 50. The point A is equal to 0 comma 50 is the first point. Similarly, put y is equal to 0. If you put y is equal to 0, you will get x is equal to 100. Therefore, the point B is equal to 100 comma 0. This is the first point. Now, the next inequality is 2x minus y is less than or equal to 0 can be written as 2x minus y is equal to 0. That means 2x is equal to y. Y is equal to 2x. The points are x comma 2x. So, we can choose any value for this. So, since the values are 10, 20, 30, 40, you can take x is equal to 20. If x is equal to 20, y, this 2x, y is nothing but 2 into 20 is equal to 40. Let us take d is equal to, when x is equal to 50, y is equal to 50 into 2 is 100. These are the two points. Okay. Now, let us come to the next. 2x plus y is equal to 200. If you put x is equal to 0, you will get y is equal to 200. Therefore, another point C, D, E, E is equal to 0 comma 200. And put y is equal to 0, you will get 2x is equal to 200. X is equal to 200 divided by 2 is nothing but 100. So, therefore, F, the coordinate F is equal to 100 comma 0. So, these are the coordinates A, B, C, D, E, F. Now, let us represent this on a graph sheet. Consider the scale for this, the points. Let me start. Now, A, what is A? A is equal to, what is A? 0, 50. B, B, B is 100, 0. C, what is C? C, 20, 40. And D, 50, 100, and E, E is 0, 200, F, what is F? F is 100, 0. Since we have 200 maximum on the y-axis, therefore, consider the scale on x-axis and y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 20 units. Let me consider 1 centimeter is equal to 20 units. So, this is origin 0 comma 0 x-axis. So each unit is equal to 20 centimeters. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, 160, 180, this is 200. Similarly, here also this is 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, 160, 180 and 200 on the y-axis. Okay, the suitable scale is 1 centimeter is equal to 20 units. Now, let us draw the graph now. A, what is A? 0 comma 50. X is 0, Y is 50. 50 comes here. A, this is A, 0 comma 50. Now, B, what is B? 100 comma 0. This is 100 comma 0. B, 100 comma 0. Now, draw a straight line. This is the line. What is the equation for this? So, first equation x plus 2y is greater than or equal to 100. This is x plus 2y is greater than or equal to 100 means if it is greater than means the feasible region is away from the origin, above the origin. Now, the second one, what is C? C 20 comma 4. X is 20, y is equal to 40. 20 comma 40. So, it will come here. This is C, 20 comma 40. And what is D? 50 comma 100. So, 50 comma 100. 100 is here. So, this is 50 comma 100. D, 50 comma 100. 50 comma 100. So, that means a straight line which passes through this origin. So, what is this actually? The curve is 2x minus y is less than or equal to 0. So, this is 2x minus y is less than or equal to 0. The feasible region is towards this y. Okay. Now, the third point, E is equal to 0 comma 200. 0 and 200. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 200. So, this is E, 0 comma 200. Then, F, 100 comma 0. F is again, this is 100 comma 0. F, 100 comma 0. Now, draw a straight line. So, this is the line. Okay. Now, what is the curve? Here, the curve is x 2x plus y is less than or equal to 200. Let me rub this line. This is 2x plus y less than or equal to 200. Now, this is less than or equal to 200 means that is the towards the origin. Now, what is the feasible region we are going to get is, so this is the feasible region. Now, this is the feasible region for the given problem. Now, what are the points of contact, corner points? The corner points are, these are the corner points. This is one point, this is another point. So, that is C, A, and find out the value of this and E. Now, what is this equal to E of G? Let me, E, F, let me call it as G. So, what is the point we are going to get here? Exactly, it is and this point. Exactly, we will get X is 50 and Y is equal to 100. If you draw it on a graph sheet, definitely you will see this is the point 50 comma 100. Now, therefore, the corner points are the corner points. I will go to the next page. Therefore, corner points are, first one is, what is the first corner point? We have this point, that is A, 0 comma 50. First corner point A, 0 comma 50. This is A 0 comma 50. And this point C is 20 comma 40. C, 20 comma 40. Again, this and G 50, 100. Then last E 0, 200. These are the corner points. Already, if you want, you can take this as D itself, D or E, whatever it may be. So I will take this as D or G. Okay. So the corner points are, these are the corner points, A 0, 50, and C, this is C, C 20, 40, G or D, that is 50, 100, and E 0, 200. Now, what is the problem you are given? Maxima is Z is equal to. So therefore, what is Z? The objective function Z is equal to X plus 2Y. Now, let us draw the table. So at these points, at corner points, at 0, 50, what is the value of Z we are going to get? Z is equal to, that is 0 plus 2 into 50, this is equal to 100. Now at C, what is the value of Z we are going to get? So this is 20 plus 2 into 40. So 20 plus 40 into 2 is 80, this is equal to 100. Now at D, Z is equal to X is 50 plus 2 into 100. So this is 200 plus 50. 200 plus 50, this is equal to 250. Now at E, Z is equal to X is 0 plus 2 into Y is 200. This is equal to 400. So these are the values. What is to find? To find the minimum and maximum, minimum value and maximum value. What is the minimum value here? This is minimum value, and one more minimum is there. This is also minimum. That means there are two minimum values. Minimum value, there are two minimum values, and this is the maximum value. Okay. So therefore, minimum, there are two minimum values. This is one minimum value and this is another minimum value. So there are two minimum values and one maximum value. So that is max. Therefore, the function is maximum at 0, 200, and maximum value is 400. Minimum value is 100 at, what are the two points? At 0, 50 and 20, 40. So therefore, the given function is minimum at 0, 50 and 20, 40, the minimum value is 100, and maximum at 0, 200, and the maximum value is 400. This is how we are going to solve this LPP problem. Hope you followed this. Now let us come to the next problem. Solve the following linear programming problem graphically. Maximize Z is equal to 3x plus 2y subjected to the constraints. X plus 2y is less than or equal to 10. 3x plus y is less than or equal to 15. And X is greater than or equal to 0. Y is greater than or equal to 0. Two equations are given. Now let us convert. First, convert the given linear inequalities into equalities. The given equation can be written as X plus 2y is equal to 10, and another equation is 3x plus y is equal to 15. Now if you put X is equal to 0, you will get 2y is equal to 10. Y is equal to 10 by 2 is 5. Therefore, A is equal to 0, 5. Now put Y is equal to 0, you will get X is equal to 10. So therefore, the point B is equal to 10, 0. Similarly, if you come to the second equation, put X is equal to 0, Y is equal to 15. Therefore, C is equal to 0, 15. Put Y is equal to 0, you will get 3X is equal to 15. X is equal to 15 by 3 is equal to 5. The point D is equal to 5, 0. And what are the conditions given? X is greater than or equal to 0 and y is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, these are the points. Now, let us represent this on a graph sheet. So, what are the points? Therefore, A, write down the points A, B, C, D. What is A? A is equal to 0, 5. What is B? B, 10, 0. What is C? C, C is 0, 15. And D, 5, 0. Now, let us take a scale. Consider a suitable scale on x-axis and y-axis. 1 centimeter is equal to 2 units. So, here this is x-axis, the origin 0, 0 on the x-axis. This is, consider it is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 and 20. On the y-axis also, this is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 and 20. A, what is A? 0, 5. A, x is 0, y is 5. 5 comes here. This is A, 0, 5. What is B? 10, 0. X is 10. This is B, 10, 0. Draw a straight line. This is the straight line. What is the equation? X plus 2y is less than or equal to 10. The equation is x plus 2y is less than or equal to 10 means the feasible region is in the downwards direction. Now, second, C, 0, 15. 0, 15, 14, here it is 15. C, 0, 15. And what is D? 5, 0. This is 5, D, 5, 0. So, this is the line. What is the condition? 3x plus y is less than or equal to 50. This is 3x plus y less than or equal to 15. So, the feasible region is also in the downwards direction. Now, so, this is the feasible region. So, this is the feasible region. What are the corner points? The corner points are, so 0, then this is A, 0, 5, and what is this point we are going to get? A, B, C, D, E. Solve this. So, straight away you can, if you draw the graph on a graph sheet, the points you are going to get here is, you will get the point like this. X is equal to 4 and y is equal to 3. If you draw a graph properly, the points you are going to get is 4, 3. X is 4, y is 3. So, therefore, the corner points O, 0, 0, then A, 0, 5, then E, 4, 3, and D, what is D? 5, 0. These are the corner points. Now, what is the objective function? The objective function is max z. Maximum z is equal to, max z is equal to 3x plus 2y. Now, at, let us come to this, at corner point O, 0, 0, A, 0, 5, at E, 4, 3, and D, 5, 0. What are the values we are going to get? Z is equal to 3x plus 2y. Let me check. So, Z is equal to 0. Now, here Z is equal to 3 into 0 is 0 plus 5 2s are 10. This is equal to 10. And at this,
4 comma 3, z is equal to 3 into 4 is 12 plus 3 into 2 is 6, this is equal to 18. At D, 5 comma 0, z is equal to 5 threes are 15 plus 0 is equal to 15. Now, what is the maximum? The intention is to get the maximum value. What is the maximum value here? The maximum value is 18. This is the maximum value. So, this is the maximum at 4 comma 3. So, therefore, the given function is maximum at 4 comma 3 and maximum value is 18. So, the given function is maximum at 4 comma 3 and the maximum value is 18. This is how we are going to solve the given linear programming problem. Now, let us come to the next problem. Solve the following linear programming problem graphically. Minimize z is equal to minus 3x plus 4y. Minimize z is equal to minus 3x plus 4y. Subject to the constraints. So, x plus 2y is less than or equal to 8. 3x plus 2y is less than or equal to 12. And x is greater than or equal to 0. Y is equal to greater than or equal to 0. The non-negative restriction. So, here also, there are two inequalities. Let us convert these two inequalities into equalities. Now, converting this into equalities, the given equation can be written as x plus 2y is equal to 8 and another equation is x plus 2y is equal to 12. Now, if you put x is equal to 0, you will get 2y is equal to 8. Y is equal to 8 by 2 is 4. Therefore, the first point A is equal to 0 comma 4. Similarly, put y is equal to 0, we will get x is equal to 8. Therefore, b is equal to 8 comma 0. Now, a is 0 comma 4 and b is 8 comma 0. Whereas in the second equation, put x is equal to 0, we will get 2y is equal to 12. Y is equal to 12 by 2 is 6. Therefore, c is equal to 0 comma 6. Again, put y is equal to 0, you will get 3x is equal to 12. X is equal to 12 by 3 is equal to 4. Therefore, other point D is equal to 4 comma 0. So, what are the points? A 0 comma 4, B is equal to 8 comma 0, C 0 comma 6 and D 4 comma 0. And the non-negative restrictions are X is greater than or equal to 0 and Y is greater than or equal to 0. Now, let us draw this on a graph. I'll go to the next page. What is A? A is equal to 0 comma 4. What is B? B 8 comma 0. And what is C? C is 0 comma 6. And what is D? D is 4 comma 0. So, these are the points. Now, let us consider a suitable scale. Scale on x-axis and y-axis. Let us take maximum is 8. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit because we have 10 here. This is x-axis, y-axis, 0 comma 0. Let us represent this as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 on the x-axis. Similarly, on the y-axis, each unit is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, now what is the first point? A 0 comma 4. X is 0, y is 4. This is A 0 comma 4. What is B? 8 comma 0. 8. This is 8 comma 0. B 8 comma 0. Draw a straight line. This is the line. What is the equation here? X plus 2y is less than or equal to 8. X plus 2y is less than or equal to 8. Less than or equal to 8 means since the feasible region is towards the origin, goes in the downwards direction. Now, what is the second equation? C is equal to 0 comma 6. 0 comma 6. This is C. 0 comma 6. C. Now, what is D? 4 comma 0. This is D. 4 comma 0. So, draw a line. this is. Okay. Now, since what is this equation? What is the equation? 3x plus 2y is less than or equal to 12. 3x plus 2y is less than or equal to 12. Less than or equal to 12 means, again, this is also in the downwards direction. That is towards the, or so this is the feasible region. Shade this. So, if you draw this on a graph sheet, exactly this will cuts at this point. Then you are going to get E is equal to, X is equal to 2 and Y is equal to 3. At this point it will cuts, you will get the value of E as 2 comma 3. So, therefore the corner points are, what are the corner points we have? Therefore, the corner points are O 0 comma 0, then come to this A 0 comma 4, then come to this point E 2 comma 3, then again come to this point D 4 comma 0. These are the corner points. See here, 0 comma 0, A 4 comma 0 comma 4, E 2 comma 3 and D 4 comma 0 are the corner points. Okay. Now, what is the objective function given? Minimize Z is equal to, what is the objective function? Minimize Z is equal to, Z is equal to minus 3x plus 4y. Minus 3x plus 4y. This is the objective function. Now, at 0 comma 0, let us draw Z is equal to minus 3x plus 4y. What are the answer we are going to get? At 0 comma 0, at A 0 comma 4, at E 2 comma 3 and at D 4 comma 0. Let us see what are the answers we are going to get. Now, Z is equal to, this is 0, and Z is equal to minus 3 into 0 plus 4 into 4, this is equal to 16. Z is equal to minus 3 into x is 2 plus 4 into y is 3, this is minus 6 plus 4 is at 12, this is equal to plus 6. At 4 comma 0, Z is equal to minus 3 into 4 plus 0, this is equal to minus 12. So, what is the minimum value? As you know, negative value itself is the minimum here. The minimum value is minus 12. Minimum value. This is the minimum value. So, therefore, the minimum value of the function is minus 12. Minus 12 is the minimum value at what is the point? At 4 comma 0. So, the function is minimum at 4 comma 0 and the minimum value is minus 12. That's it. That is how we are going to solve a linear programming problem graphically. Okay. So, practice this. Definitely, you will get one question and very easy to get 6 marks. Okay, that's all regarding today's session. Let us meet with the different problems, the formation of the linear programming and the solution. Let me discuss in the next class the formation and the solution of a linear programming problem. That's all for today's session. Thank you very much.